Welcome back everyone. So in this video I will be showing you the easiest way to run or install the APK file on Windows 10 or 11 PC and laptop. Now majority of us want to enjoy the Android application or game on our PC, but for which you have to either go with an emulator or some other method which create a lot of confusion, and many of you even have got failed to install it. But no problem, I will be sharing the easiest method, so make sure that you do not skip any part or else the method will not work for you. And before starting guys, make sure that you hit the like, subscribe, turn the bell notification on so that you can get all these useful videos notification in the future. You can also join my membership where you can live chat with me to fix any of your PC and laptop problem. Now the very first thing that you have to do on your PC or laptop, that you will have to enable the virtualization from the BIOS. Now many people reported, I have seen many comments that people saying that the method is not working for them, and I have found that this is just because you have not enabled the virtualization. So you can enable the virtualization from the BIOS. I have already created a video on that, and in order to check the status, you can right click on Windows icon, go to Task Manager, click on the Performance tab, and here on the right hand corner you can see the virtualization and my status shows enabled. But if you find it disabled, then you will have to enable it. And in case if you don't find the virtualization option, then there is not any kind of surety that this method will work for you or not. But still you can give a try. Once you have enabled, next what you will have to do, click on your Windows search, type turn Windows, and in the suggestion you will have to click on turn Windows feature on or off. And here you will have to enable a few features like virtual machine platform and Windows hypervisor platform. If both these options are being checked on your end, then you will have to check it, then you will have to click on OK, and after this it will be applying the changes and probably it will ask you to restart the computer. So go ahead and restart the computer, and once it gets restarted, now you will have to download and install the Windows subsystem for Android, and that you can download from the Microsoft store. So click on your Windows search, look for the store, and then here you will have to search for Windows subsystem for Android. So once you get it, you will have to go ahead and download it and install it. But in case many of you might not find Windows subsystem for Android in the Microsoft store, for many other locations like for India and many other Asian countries. In case if you don't find in Microsoft store, then no problem. I will be sharing a link in the description. You will have to come to this GitHub website, and here you can download the Windows subsystem for either Windows 11 or Windows 10. I'm using here Windows 11, so I will go with Windows 11. So I will click on the first link that says download latest pre-release build Windows 11 x64. And then you will have to scroll down to the bottom. And under the asset section, you will find WSA release nightly mind the game removed Amazon. Okay, so you will have to click on it. And it's around 646 MB, so it will take some time. So you will have to wait until it's all been downloaded. Alright, so once it will be installed in a zip file, so open the downloaded folder. Right click on the zip file, go up to WinRAR and click on extract file. Now choose the location wherever you want to extract the file. I will go with the document, select it and click on OK. And this will be start extracting the file. So again, it may take few seconds, so just wait until it's all been done. And once it will be done, again I have to go back to document. And here I can find the WSA folder now. Open the extracted folder. And here now you will be getting all these kind of files. Now here the file that you have to look for will be by the name install.ps1. That is a Windows PowerShell script. Now before running it, what you have to do additionally so that you should not have any kind of problem. Click on your Windows search. Type gpedit. Click on edit group policy. The group policy editor will be up. Now in case if you get any kind of error while opening the group policy, then probably you are using any kind of Windows 11 or 10 home edition. For that I have already created a video, you can check that video, and then you can enable this option. Okay, so once you come to group policy editor, under computer configuration you will have to click on administrative template. Then from the right hand side you will have to click on Windows component, double click on it, and here you have to look for Windows PowerShell. So come to the W section and look for Windows PowerShell. Here it is. Double click on it. And then you have to look for turn on script execution. Again, double click on it. This will bring up the new box. And here it will be selected to not configured. You will have to choose enabled. And below in the execution policy, make sure it's been selected to allow all scripts. Once done, you will have to click on apply. Click on OK. Now, once you are done with this, you can come back to this group policy editor page and again, you can disable it. All right, so now we are ready to run this install file. So you will have to make a right click on it and click on run with PowerShell. Click on yes and the process will be started. Now you will have to click on continue and the Windows subsystem for Android will now be loading up. All right, so once it comes up, you will have to close the settings. And now it will ask you to sign in with your Google account. So you can click on sign in and then just type your email account of Google, and it can be of your mobile phone only that you are using in your mobile phone, or you can use any kind of other Gmail account as well. So type your email and password, click on next. Bingo. So now you can see the Google Play Store is up, and from here only you can download and install any kind of application, any kind of Android game easily by just clicking on it. Alright, now additionally, if you only want to download any kind of APK file on your Windows PC and laptop, then what you will have to do, you can minimize it. Now in the Windows system for Android, you will have to click on advanced setting and then you will have to enable the developer mode. So just enable it. So once you have enabled, now you can minimize it. So as I said that you have two options now, either you can download the application directly from the Play Store. But if you want to run any kind of APK file, then for that you will have to open a new tab in your browser and you have to search for WSA Pacman and click on the first link of GitHub. I will also leave the direct link in the description. Now once you come up here on the right hand side, you will find in the releases WSA Pacman, click on the latest. And here in the asset section, you will have to click on WSA Pacman 1.5.0 installer.exe. Click on it. And it's a small file of around 35 MB, so it won't take much time. Once it gets downloaded, again click on the downloaded file. Click on yes. Click on next. 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 Install. And finish. Now you can search for the Pacman. In the suggestion, you will be getting WSA Pacman, so you will have to open it. And now it says allow ADB debugging, so you will have to click on allow. Now once it will be connected, you will be getting this kind of message, connected, successfully connected to WSA, all system, go. Alright, so you will have to make sure that this status should be set to connected. So you are good to go, and now you can install any kind of APK file on your Windows PC and laptop. So let me quickly bring up an APK file here. So I have this Indian Bike Driving 3D31.apk file. So I will just make a double click on it. Choose WSA Package Manager. Click on always and then I have to click on install. The installation will now be started. So wait for some time until the installation is being finished and it says the application Indian Bike Driving 3D was successfully installed. If you want to create a desktop shortcut, then you can check this option and then you can click on open app. Okay, so that's all guys for today. Hopefully you found this video helpful and I'm very sure that this method will be working for you and you would be able to enjoy the Android application or game on your Windows PC and laptop. And if this method worked for you guys, do not forget to like and subscribe and I see you in the next video. Bye bye.